remember right now.
Okay, okay.
Where I did something besides, like,
it wasn't up.
No. Okay. So, yeah.
Hi, YouTube.
Really?
Yeah. Can't so, do you have a favorite birthday gift? Like, what's the... Mm-hmm. Or if you haven't gotten one yet, what would be your favorite birthday?
I got a giant pterodactyl toy.
Okay.
From my dad.
Wow. How big? Show with your hands.
I was like, this. Like,
whoa,
the wingspan
no
was legit. And I swear my neighbor stole it, and if I ever find them, I'm a Gemini, I hold a grudge.
Wait.
I will find them.
So, like, how old were you when you received the
I was like five or okay. six or something like that.
So you think that the dinosaurs did exist, right?
Yes, I am a believer. I believe in the dinosaurs. There are skeletons of them, so I would be...
Yeah, but like, how do you know they weren't just like put there? Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's the most elaborate art installation I've ever seen. That's the case.
Did you go through like a dinosaur phase when you were a kid?
Pterodactyls were always my favorite, and I just recently found out that they weren't technically dinosaurs.
True.
So that is really fascinating
to
me.
What were they?
They were something else.
Winged reptiles.
Oh, Pluto's not a planet.
Winged reptiles.
Wow.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
They like just
I think
didn't
they were
classify
gonna
dinosaurs.
Yeah.
I think it's because they didn't have feathers. I think that was really.
Wait. So it's funny though that the pterodactyls, the flying dinosaurs, are not.
Dinosaurs,
but
mm-hmm.
birds are descendants of dinosaurs.
Right.
So they really got the short end.
So that's
why
I'm saying, like, have you ever even,
stick.
Like, have you said
like I'm, this is not a platform for this, but some important dinosaur knowledge for all of you. Velociraptor. About yay high.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
and feathered, right?
And totally feathered. Looked like a wild turkey.
Did they still have the big toe, though?
Yes.
Because that's my favorite.
Toe.
That's my favorite part.
But, like, with all this evidence now, Steve, like, are you sure that they really did exist? Because, like, no one seems to
Everything
know really
seems
what
to
they
be
lost.
Like,
yeah. Well, there's 23andMe now. There's so much we can do with dinosaur bones.
Oh, so you're saying that our own DNA is linked to dinosaurs now?
No, I'm not saying that. That's
also,
crazy.
Hold up. Are you saying that... When the technology presents itself, you are looking forward to a Jurassic Park scenario?
As long as they still have those Jeeps on the track. Because I was always a fan of the antique cars at amusement parks. But it would be like that, but with a radio.
Okay. So a fan of the antique cars, but you could see past all the dyes.
I think the best part is that your favorite part of the park where dinosaurs are resurrected from the dead are the car that's attached to a track and goes 5 miles an hour. That's the technological advancement you're most excited about.
Think about how fun it is to know you're in a non-fuel efficient vehicle that isn't burning fuel.
But if you like, you watch the movie, there's nothing connecting those Jeeps to those rails, right? Like,
no.
They're just driving on top
of
them.
Jeff Goldblum.
It's just Jeff Goldblum.
Steve, is there a conspiracy theory that you genuinely do believe in?
Ooh.
That's good. Oh.
Like, what's your fringiest idea?
Like, what, or like one that like really just grinds your gears that you hate when people say it?
Oh. I don't know. I'm such a good boy, I don't think about that.
You're too polite to believe in conspiracy theories, is what you're saying.
Well, I do believe that Santa poked me as a child.
Ew!
Okay.
Wait, what?
Okay.
Whoa, no,
Santa,
no.
You know the old conspiracy theory that Santa pokes kids? Pokes some designs.
Hey, you asleep? You sleep?
Blankets over my head, and I was especially suspicious that if Santa ever saw you, he would never deliver gifts to you again.
Okay.
So I made sure I covered my head, and I think Santa was just doing a little, like, vital check.
Light reconnaissance.
Like, is he gonna move? And I heard, like, a jingle bell. It was so elaborate.
There's no other possible explanation.
Well, how can leave toys in the kid you have,
right? You have a sister.
Yeah, I have a sister.
Couldn't have possibly been her messing with you.
No, she was on the top bunk. She also believed that Santa would not give us gifts. She wouldn't do me dirty.
Yeah, I think I know somebody. Dinosaur bigger.
It's too small.
It's too small. It's perfect size.
Too small. Come on. People want to see the giant Tyrannosaurus. They want to see the Brontosaurus. If we bring this in, we're going to be the laughing stocks of the paleontology community.
That's not actually how big it is. They just make things bigger than they are.
Despite the fact that it's still alive. Making these cute, adorable noises. It's too cute. It's too cute. It's an adorable pet, and I'm not going to risk my paleontology career on a cute, something that would make me a stuffed
animal. You're telling me,
Dr.
Snyder, that a dinosaur can't be cute?
I agree. That's what I'm saying. Dinosaurs aren't supposed to be cute. They're supposed to be terrible, vicious creatures who were smited by God.
God?
Yeah, that's another thing. Why are we not, like, all of a sudden paleontologists can't be religious and say that God put the bones in the earth?
I've read Genesis. It doesn't say, like, on the sixth day God created dinosaurs.
All I'm saying is that I know people are laughing at us. We are pathetic paleontologists.
I'm not a
pathetic
paleontologist. Don't yell it!
I yell at small animals! I find them to be weaker than me, so I have to bully them.
Well, Bertrand is very delicate.
What?
Bertrand is very delicate.
Bertrand?
Bertrand. I named him.
You named the... What did you name it?
Bertrand.
That's the dumbest name. What name is that?
It's a cute name for a cute dinosaur.
Bertrand.
Bertrand.
Ooh.
Bertrand?
Who loves Bertrand?
No, I need you to tell me what you're saying. Are you saying Bertrand?
Bertrand. B-E-R-T-R-A-N. Bertrand.
Name one person named Bertrand in the world. Now.
It's a dinosaur. I'm not going to name it a person name.
You are creating.
What are you going to call
it? Oh, my God.
It's Bob the dinosaur.
That's a normal name. God created the dinosaur. You can't create names.
I can't work with you.
I can't work with Bertrand. Bertrand.
I am taking my dinosaur and I'm going to another department.
We found that dinosaur in a dumpster, to both of us. You put it down. Don't make me yell at you like a small animal.
I bought the crate.
Yeah, fine. I owe you $5. Can you put it down?
Shh, it's okay, Bertrand.
If it's going to be...
Mommy and Daddy are just fighting. It's fine. We're going to be fine.
Mommy and Daddy?
I wanted to think it comes for a normal, everyday, middle-class
home.
You
want that thing to think that I gave birth to it?
Well, I'm not the mother.
I'm not the mother either. What makes you think I'm motherly in the least bit?
Well, you're the first one that found it, so the first thing it saw, it's going to think it's its mother.
I heard it because I thought it was my burrito talking to me.
Well, I'm the one who grabbed your ankles and lowered you into the dumpster so you could get it. So the first face, the Bertrand saw was yours, that makes you mom.
We're also forgetting the main thing. My burrito is still in that dumpster and I'm starving.
Well, that's your fault. You had two hands. You could have gotten Bertrand with one and the burrito with the other. You made a choice.
You made a choice by daring me that I wouldn't eat my burrito after putting it in a dumpster. And I still am going to win that bet, because I will eat that. I'm going to eat this. I'm going to eat Bertrand.
I'm taking
burrito.
You're not going to threaten my dinosaur.
It's our dinosaur.
It's my dinosaur if you're going to threaten it.
I'm going to publish a paper, put it in the Science Journal that says you are a mean person.
I'm gonna take you to court for custody.
It's not a child. We are not the parents of a beast. For all we know, it's probably a feral cat.
How dare you?
Well, honestly, how do you know it's really a dinosaur? We didn't do any scientific research. We literally just found it. This is why we're being made fun of by other paleontologists.
Would you like to hear the story of the Tooth Fairy again?
Yes, Bobby.
After you've put the tooth under your pillow, cover your mouth with duct tape. Elsewhile, the tooth fairy will come into your bedroom and pluck every tooth from your head. Baby and adult.
But
she'll get them all.
Bashmi, why does the tooth fairy want our teeth so badly?
Who knows what she does with them? All we know is that she wants them badly.
If we don't put the duct tape on and she takes them, does she not leave a transactional relationship with you?
No, she'll leave something behind.
But not money.
Not always.
Lakshmi, I hear when the tooth fairy comes, if you don't duct tape your mouth, she crawls inside and leaves you bad dreams.
Bad dreams because you have no teeth.
Also, there's a fairy in your mouth, and that's kind of weird, too.
It's one of the less weird parts of the arrangement, but yeah.
Babshi, I heard that sometimes she'll leave a shoe.
One of her tiny fairy shoes, yes. Most swallow them before they wake.
But if you don't, what happens? Does she come to visit you and leave you another
shoe? She'll just take back the shoe. That's and leave cool. An angry note taped to the inside of your gums.
How does she write a note when she's only 3 feet?
It's a small note.
Popsy. A girl at school told me that the tooth fairy is not real, that it's just our parents.
You keep your distance from that girl! Don't get near her! She's been mocked!
Mocked by she?
Mocked by the fairy queen!
Little Michael Carmichael told me that the tooth fairy's bankrupt.
Little Michael Carmichael wishes the tooth fairy was bankrupt. He's marked as well. She'll be coming for him when he least expects it. Where do you think plaque comes from?
I read in a science book that plaque comes from germs that live in your mouth all day, Babshi.
What have we said about mentioning science books in this den?
Science books are the tool of the devil.
Yes.
The moon landing was just orchestrated by the serpent.
That's right.
You.
Hey, Carl, no problem, man. I mean, look, you only turn 25 once in a lifetime, right?
Oh, man.
Figured let's just make it a good one.
Let's just rent a car and drive.
Just as far as we can. And never look back.
No maps, no plans, just you and me.
Just turn off the GPS, put our phones on silent. Yep. I threw mine out the window a couple miles back.
Wow.
Yeah. Dude, come on, man. It's your special day. I'm so glad we couldn't spring for the electric windows.
I'm only 25.
I know, man. Future's bright.
Oh, man.
Future's bright and as far and shiny and as clear and in our vision as the road in front of us.
It's just so wide and open. So many possibilities. Oh, shit.
It's all right. Sometimes life gives you some bumps and things you need to avoid, but you know what? No looking back!
Wow. That was really adventurous.
I don't know, man. I don't know what just came over me, but it felt good. It felt real good, Carl.
I feel like I need to look at these side mirrors a little bit more frequently now just to make sure. Ah! Oh boy.
Not today, Carl.
John.
We're living for now.
John, I'm starting to get a little uncomfortable. Starting to get a little worried.
That's life, man. That's life creeping up on you, you know? Sometimes the adrenaline just gets too much. You just gotta not think about it. You just gotta put your foot down harder on the gas. You just gotta
Whoa! How'd you get your leg over the median? You just slide your leg over there.
Just sheer willpower and determination.
Whoa.
Carl, you can't let anything get in your way. Not a median. What do you want to do whenever we finally get to wherever it is we're going?
Just get my inhaler out of the back. And just
not gonna happen, man. I chucked it while you were in the bathroom.
That is a medical need. I'm gonna have a bad evening.
No way, dude. You don't
without
need
that inhaler.
You don't need that inhaler, man. You need the fresh air of freedom.
No,
roll that window down, buddy.
No. My airwaves, they just kind of tighten up.
The open road's your inhaler now,
oh, boy. You do not know anything about doctors.
Dude, I stopped caring about doctors the minute my health insurance ran out. No looking back, buddy. That's our motto on this road trip. So Sorry, I'm relieving myself right now. I don't want you to stop.
Really wish we hadn't thrown out all the bottles.
Yeah, but man, it feels so good to be alive, you know? Just feeling it, you know? Sometimes you just...
Your urine shell's really strong.
I drank a lot of coffee this morning, buddy. A lot of coffee.
Just really strong.
Just, that's life, man. That's the aroma of life. Just tickling your nostrils, footloose, fancy free, without a need to stop for anything.
You got a lot of smoke going out in the exhaust. The only reason I can see that is because our one remaining mirror.
Carl, I get the feeling you're really not enjoying this birthday trip as much as you were when we first got started, buddy.
I like to live dangerously. This is really pushing me beyond, look at the road, beyond what I thought was
Carl, look
safety.
At me. Carl, look at me. Don't look at the road. Look at me. Carl, don't look at the road. You look at me when I'm talking to you, buddy.
John!
This is your life, man.
John!
This is your life. You're 25. You're a quarter centurion.
I don't want to die.
Read, neither do I, buddy, but there's only one way to find
we're
out.
We're on the rumble strip, John!
All right, you go. You look. When are you gonna ask me to dance?
Eustace, it's 2018. If you want to dance, you can go ahead and ask one of us to dance.
At my own spring debut.
Listen here in Sprint, Tennessee.
Sprint, Tennessee?
Sprink. The name of the town in which we live, you...
I'm sorry, I can't read.
It's easy. Eligible gentleman be
Jebediah. You've been real quiet. You don't want to dance with me, Miss Eustace Mayweather? My spring coming out.
Eustace, I was fancy on you for as long as I could remember. Well, now that you're eligible, I'm just not interested anymore.
Yeah, Di, is it because you saw my hammer toes in the creek? I'm wearing open toe shoes.
I'm not a red man. I'm not one to read many books, but you remember the book by Roald Dahl, The Witches?
Where she sticks her finger in the air and all the birds fly around.
Well, they didn't have toes. And there was an illustration in the book. And that illustration was just a rectangle to show what their foot looked like. That's what your foot looks like.
I have toes, Jebediah. They're just shy.
To be frank with you, I would have loved your toes, or lack thereof, years ago when I first propositioned you. But now it's just not alluring to me anymore.
I couldn't date you then, Jebediah.
Why?
Because typhoid fever was running rampant in the village. I couldn't go outside and get my delicate complexion muddied with a disease.
The more times you talk about all the bad things that occur to you, the fact that you have to constantly be fanning yourself because of your horrible condition where you sweat constantly.
I sweat constantly. I look glazed.
Eunice, it just took me realizing that you're just not an attractive person.
Well, I beg to differ. Isn't that right, Abraham?
Lordy, please don't ask me any questions.
Kiss my sweaty ring.
Well, Dylan, what happened to your pinky? You ain't got no pinky now?
It fell off.
Okay, just stand right there, okay? And don't move a muscle.
Okay.
Stand up straight, please, okay?
Sorry.
Look, no one can know that I found you. No one can know that aliens exist. Because if they exist, they're gonna see you. And
and they're going to think that I am a real terrible scientist for discovering you because you're a little bitch.
Bertram, I don't see what the big deal is.
Don't
this
call
is
me
amazing
that.
Scientific.
Don't you call me Bertram. Bertram.
Sorry, it's a very popular name where I come from.
Oh, that's like me calling you buddy or pal.
I don't know what those words mean, but I'm assuming it's a synonym. Look, I'm
You're such an idiot! I don't like you!
Oh, I'm sorry, the idiot who flew 3,000 light years to come to some backwater planet by accident? He's the idiot?
Well, you know, 3,000 light years in the scope of the universe is not that far away.
Oh, I'm sorry, if you've traveled more than outside of your own atmosphere, raise your hand.
Oh! This is what I'm talking about. You're a bitch. Bitch, I mean.
You know what?
And I don't think I want to write a paper about you.
I'm sorry. It's just a problem that I have when I see inferior life forms from other species.
Oh, and now I'm inferior.
I bullied them. I'm sorry.
I'm the bully. I'm supposed to bully you.
Look, whatever counts as bullying on this planet might work for you, but where I come from, it's a huge strata above whatever it is that's going on around here.
Why are you the way you are?
I'm sorry.
Is this how everyone on your planet acts? Just being like a smarmy, I know everything, I'm so cool.
No, everybody on my planet's super chill. That's why we go to other planets to push them around. It's a superiority thing. Every other planet that I've ever shown up on, they treat me like a god. I'm like somebody from outside of their solar system who's visited them with vast swaths of knowledge. You're the first prick I've ever bumped into on a planet who's like, I can't tell anybody about you. I thought you were a scientist or anything.
I am, but I don't want to be embarrassed. I'm already the laughing stock of the science community.
For what?
I don't want to say.
Oh, looks like Bertram's got a little dirt.
I thought the moon was Mars. Like, it was a stupid mistake.
Oh, my God.
I was like, wow, wait, Mars is really close. And then, like, instantly I said, oh, wait, it's the moon. But everybody heard me say it.
Oh, my God, are you kidding me? That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. I'm from a solar system that is nowhere near here, and even I know the difference between all of your planets and planetoids and moons. Because I have vastly superior knowledge of everything.
I don't like when you touch me.
It's just because my tendrils, they seep a little bit of your brain energy every time I...
Are you kidding me? You're also taking my brain energy?
It's also kind of a thing that we do when we visit.
This is the great filter that humans are experiencing, huh? This is what's going to do us in, is a bunch of bullies from the bully planet coming in and calling us all Bertrand.
Oh no, actually, it's going to be global warming, but I just wanted to call dibs before this whole place was underwater. So I figured it'd be a quick jaunt here. Wow, everybody.
I'm just asking, could you do something that's like cool? Be cool like on Earth standards, like do a magic trick.
A magic trick?
Magic is so cool.
I have trans-dimensional travel capabilities and you want me to pull a rabbit out of a fucking hat?
I'm glad you know what a rabbit is.
I read my books before I came here because I'm a man of science, unlike a certain Earthling who has the audacity to talk down to me.
You know what? You know what's cool?
I'm assuming not you.
What are you talking about? I can chug a Dr. Pepper in like 2 seconds.
What the fuck is a Dr. Pepper?
You know what a rabbit is, but you just don't know what a Dr. Pepper is. Dr. Pepper's like the greatest son on the planet. No one likes rabbit more than Dr. Pepper.
Rabbits are a life form, part of a giant web, an ecosystem where all
Dr.
life is
Dr. Pepper is a doctor.
Stop lying to my kids. You should stop telling them all these stories about monsters coming into their bedroom at night. If you go home, I have to stay with them. I have to hear them crying. They don't sleep. Tooth Fairy's gonna steal all their teeth.
Listen, Lucas, if you want to deny science and factual information, put your children at risk. That is on you. I am going to protect my grandchildren any way I can. Lucas.
So you're going to stand by that? You're going to stand stand by? You stand by that tooth fairy coming to steal all your teeth? That Santa coming in stealing everybody's toys and replacing them with little robots that spy on them?
Right.
They think their teddy bears are spying on them.
They are. And the Easter Bunny gives them salmonella. I'm okay with that one. I think Easter's bullshit anyway. How did I raise you?
I'm just real scared to go to bed because Grandpa said that if I catch a glimpse of the Easter Bunny, he'll give me penicillin-resistant staph.
Christopher, just go back to your bedroom.
What if I get a staph infection because of the Easter Bunny?
Just don't look at anything. Just close your eyes and sleep.
But I had this part of my wind down process. I turn each sense off individually, and sight is the last. I can't help it if he comes into my room, because he always leaves a basket in my room. He has to leave a basket in my room.
He's gonna leave a basket in your room. That's the Easter Bunny's calling card, but he's not.
He's gonna give me a penicillin resistant
He will not give you a staph infection.
And I'm gonna be in an urgent care.
Christopher,
the last time we went to urgent care, you said that's a $150 copay.
It was $150! That was intended to be used for Easter lunch. And well, then we had to eat sandwiches at home.
Because I thought I saw him and I was like, here I go. I'm gonna meet Jesus.
That is not how a staph infection works.
Everyone knows you get the staph infection and then 2 days later, Jesus calls you home. Ring, ring, it's Jesus.
See, I would say that you have an active imagination, but I know that is my dad. That is grandfather lying to you.
You should wait till you hear what he told me about Krampus.
Oh, no.
All right. So, 14 heavily armed unsubs in that building right there. We're gonna storm in, slice the pie, take them all down. And gentlemen, this is not our first rodeo, but I do believe we've been going about things the wrong way. Here at SWAT, so today I want to try things just I don't know, I want to be a little looser.
Sir, it's against protocol to remove your helmet and your flak jacket.
Yeah.
You threw your gun there. Yeah.
I know.
Okay, I know what's happening. Sir.
The place is fired to blow. Don't try anything funny, or I swear to God.
I might try something funny.
We won't do anything funny.
It might be funny. You don't know.
No. Listen to me, sir.
You can't guarantee that. I've got some routines.
I get it. It's your birthday. You just turned 40. I get it.
This is not a time to practice your stand-up. I'm so.
You are not having a midlife crisis.
I'm
okay?
So old.
You're not old.
I'm
40.
So old. No, I'm only 40.
What?
How old is he?
Don't ask!
Encourage this! Hold on, I got one. I'm so old,
How old is he?
I'm trying to, let me, do it again!
You can't have this banter with an audience if you want to be a comedian anyway!
Do it again! Start from the beginning!
Oh, for the love of God, this
I'm so old!
How old are you?
I'm so old, Jesus was my commissioner!
That's impossible.
That's terrible.
Like that's it's impossible.
I want you to try some funny business because I want something better than that.
It's the hyperbole that makes it funny.
If you have to explain the joke, then it means you haven't done your job.
Hey, why don't you just keep your mouth shut? Let us deal with this over here, yeah. And then we'll be there in a minute.
Sorry,
I'm a hostage in this situation. Please stop this.
Nobody asked you for your opinion, just be quiet.
Yeah, be quiet, hostage.
Hey, you can't talk to my hostages like that.
Well, you can't talk to my sergeant that way.
Yeah. Stop heckling our sergeant.
Yeah, I got half of one to come out there and give you a piece of it.
No, well, that's real funny.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. This is good. I have to learn how to deal with hecklers.
No, you have to get that hostage out of the building because you are a SWAT leader.
Maybe defuse the megaphone.
Don't. What are you?
Well, maybe they aren't hearing him.
No, he can make like cute fart noises in a megaphone. That's pretty funny.
That's pretty funny. That's pretty funny.
Fart noises are funny, right?
Yeah, fart noises are always funny.
I read it in a book.
Your fart noises aren't even good!
Oh god, that's terrible!
Hey, that's actually pretty good!
What?
That was pretty good!
No, he did not honor a good fart!
Well, you do better then.
I'm wearing a SWAT uniform.
I'll give you a shot.
Oh god.
It's a metaphor!
I'm gonna die at Groupon Corporate.
What?
What?
I'm gonna die in this Groupon Corporate office. Please do something.
We are!
We are!
We're trying to hone his act, I guess.
Hey, you either give in to the demands I sent you earlier, or you tell me something funny, and I'm gonna start wasting people. All right, I'm sending them out.
One mall Santa. And I just want to say, guys, we came in as strangers, and I just want you to know, no matter who gets the part, I'm just glad I got to meet you.
Okay! Right there. Good auditions all around.
Thank you.
Wonderful direction. Yes, absolutely.
Well, just, you know, I've been doing this a long time.
Shows.
I was the second, or was it the third stand-in for the Santa in Miracle on 34th Street? I know a bit about Santa.
Can you say celebrity?
I'm starstruck.
Thank you. I saw a lot of good commitment, but I'm not exactly ready to choose. I need to see a bit more on it. And what I realized is I did not ask any of you to ho-ho-ho. Can you believe that? I didn't remember that part.
You just get so into it, you know, yeah, you get so into it.
So the first one up, Brad Crandall. Give me your,
Ho ho ho.
That is not bad. That is not bad. All right. I know your name's not Michelle, but I wrote Michelle. Michael?
It's
French.
It's Michael. It's Michele.
We got like a foreign thing. Okay.
I did study at Sorbonne.
At the what?
It's a fancy French school.
Oh, nice. I did community theater in Pawtucket.
Can I just have a moment to center myself? Ho-ho-ho!
That instrument is warm.
That was really good. And next up we got this, Christopher Kringle. That name sounds familiar.
Family name.
Christopher, the Santa Claus's name.
Yes.
Your birth name is Santa Claus's name.
Yes, it is. Christopher, wow. with a K.
That is... some method acting. It's beautiful.
It's how I was born. I'm going to warm up my throat with a glass of warm milk.
Oh, none of you guys did that.
I didn't know we could use props.
Produces phlegm.
Of course you can. Give me your best go. Give me your best go. Next round's really where it happens.
Ho, ho, ho.
Okay. I have not yet come to a conclusion because they were all so wonderful. So I'm gonna have to sit on each one of your laps and piss on your laps.
God damn it! Chris, I can't tell anyone about you, okay? I get that you're the actual heir to the Santa Claus title, okay? You're a living, breathing Santa Claus. But if... look at you! You're skinny. You're hairless on the face. Like,
people can't know. You
are no one's picture of Santa Claus, right?
Nobody likes a skinny Santa, I know. But I
like if
working
I
working on my suntan. It's July, I can relax.
If I go before the other folklorists, and say, here's Santa Claus. I have conclusively proven via DNA that this is the actual real from the North Pole.
Look at my boots.
Well, no, yes, you have appropriate boots, but
jingle bells.
Yeah, okay, but nothing else fits. I'm sorry, it's just
You want me to get a red bathing suit?
I don't see how that would.
So you're telling me that you want to change your name legally from Christopher Kringle to Bertram Kringle.
Yes.
Hey, Dad. Some of the kids at school were talking. You give presents to all the good girls and boys, right?
I do.
Is it true that you give all the bad kids chlamydia?
That's a chef of